Hello everyone, welcome to English for Logistics. Today we will study Unit 6, Shipping Goods. Starter. Do you know what these markings represent? Discuss with a partner. Try to label the shipping markings with the correct words. Number 1. What is it? It is means fragile. Number 2. It means this side up. On way side up. Three. What is it? We mustn't use hooks. Use no hooks. Never use hooks. Four. Is dump stack. Do not stack. Number 5 is, what is it? It means the cargo is properly explosive. Number 6. It means fire, easy to be fired. We need to store away from heat. Store away from heat. 7. It means don't put outside under the rain. So we should keep dry. Eight is dangerous or toxic. Next, number 1. Here is an extract from a manual providing rail loading instructions. Complete the sentences with words from the box. Number 1. Vehicle carefully. So, examine vehicle carefully. Number 2. Do not place items across the wagon. Diagonally means mean this direction, across direction. Like this. Diagonally. 3. When loading is complete, ensure that it fully complies with the instructions. Given in our rail instructions manual. Number 4. Examine load carefully and make it is undamaged and suitable for loading. So here we make sure. Number 5. Longer, heavier pieces on the bottom of the load. So we place. Number 6. Make sure that load is secure. Next, 7. Ensure vehicle is to be loaded. Is fit. Eight. Strap loads. Overhanging. Overhanging. 9. When checking the vehicle, give special to draw securing mechanisms. So special attention. Special attention. 11. Load as evenly as possible and make sure wheels are evenly loaded. Oh, sorry. Give special attention here. Attention. Next, number 10. Examine vehicle and load after loading. So, examine vehicle and load carefully. Carefully. 11. Load as evenly as possible and make sure wheels are evenly loaded. Distribute load. Check whether vehicle capacity has not been the last one exceeded. Number 2. Now match the correct sentences with the instructions below. A. For before loading, we have number 1. number one and number four and seven, also nine, 1 4 7 9. B, during loading we have number 2, number 5, number 8 and 11 as well. 2 5 8 11. After loading we have number 3, number 6 and 10 9, 10 and 12, 3 6, 10 12. Number 3, match the beginning of the sentences from 1 to 8 with the endings from 8 to 8. Number 1, remove protruding letter D, staples or nails. Number 2, cover the damaged wound. Letter G, of the container. 3, secure the load to. Letter A, prevent movement. 4, fill empty. Letter A, spaces between products. 5, replace damaged pallets. Letter H, with new ones. 6, align the load. C, vertically we have vertically is this direction and this direction is horizontally. Next, 7, stack the boxes with letter B on pallets. Stack the boxes on pallets. 8, seal the container after letter F, loading is complete. Next, explaining how to do something. When explaining how to do something, you can use the imperative form of the verb. Use the infinitive without to like this. Examine the load carefully. Do not overload the vehicle. We start with infinitive. Put down to. Okay, next. Number 4. Complete this email about an urgent shipment with prepositions from the box. We have buy on with on out to between of. Sonja, I'm afraid there is a problem with the scheduled deliveries. Friends, so deliveries to our custom GLP Pharma in Brest has just informed me that they are already of stock, already out of stock. I need an urgent delivery of the 5 mg 30 and 90 piece packs this week instead of next week. If possible, we must try to make one parcel delivery. This is the date. So delivery on. Or as soon as the packaging is finished of the 5 mg 30 packs, we need a direct truck. Our production plant in Germany and Brest, so we need a preposition which is between. If we can ship the first pack on Wednesday morning, the truck should arrive Brest on Thursday afternoon. So arrive in. The second delivery should be made on Friday with the rest of the 5 mg 30 and the 90 packs as the products are needed here today. So but here we don't use preposition on. But we use by. The deadline. The truck must be unloaded in Brest on Saturday or Sunday. Please let me know if there are any problems. Regards, John Frederickson, Logistics Manager. Okay, next. Number 5. Sonja and John are discussing the urgent delivery over the phone. Listen and answer the questions. Let's listen.
Unit 6. Exercise 5.
John Fredriksson, Export Logistics.
Hi John, this is Sonja. I'm just phoning about your email.
Hi Sonja. Thanks for getting back to me so quickly. So, what can we do about GLP in France?
I think we've really got a problem here. Unfortunately, we can't use one of our regular forwarders for this shipment. I've talked to all of them, and the fastest service would take 48 hours.
Can't we use someone that specializes in express deliveries?
Not really. I've checked this option too. But I'm not sure it would work for us, because they offer a very limited loading capacity. This means that we would have several smaller partial deliveries, and we'd have to pay a lot more as a result.
What about the weekend delivery? That's possible, isn't it?
I'm afraid not. We can't deliver at the weekend. weekend because of the HDV driving ban on Saturdays and Sundays.
Oh dear. I had no idea this delivery would cause so many problems. I'll talk to GLP again, and we'll get back to you later. Thanks for your help.
No problem. Speak to you soon. Bye.
Bye.
Okay, number one. Can they use one of their usual forwarding agents? No, they can't. Two. How long would the fastest delivery service take? The fastest option takes 48 hours. Number three, would express delivery be a good option? No, because they have very limited loading capacity. Limited loading. Capacity. Number four. Why is it not possible to deliver at the weekend? Because of the HGV driving ban on Saturdays and Sundays. On Saturday and Sunday. Next, number five. What does John want to do next? He wants to call GLP and then get back to Sonia. He wants to call GLP and then get back to Sanya. Next, number six. Put the works in the order they are mentioned in the dialogue. Then listen again to check. Number one, I think we really got a problem here. Number two, use this shipment error for one. Unfortunately, we can't have regular forwarders. So, unfortunately, we can't use one of our regular forwarders for this shipment. Number three, we smaller these deliveries means pack, so that would have several. So this means that we would have several smaller parcel deliveries. Four, have to a lot more, and as we'd pay a result, we'd also have to pay a lot more as a result. Five, Saturdays and Sundays, because of delivery, we can't add the weekend driving ban on the HGV. So we reorder, we can't deliver at the weekend because of the HGV driving ban on Saturdays and Sundays. Number six, problems this delivery. No idea I would cause so many hat. I had no idea this delivery would cause so many problems. Okay, we will listen again.
Unit 6, exercise 5.
John Fredriksson, Export Logistics.
Hi John, this is Sonja. I'm just phoning about your email.
Hi Sonja, thanks for getting back to me so quickly. So what can we do about GLP in France?
I think we've really got a problem here. Unfortunately, we can't use one of our regular forwarders for this shipment. I've talked to all of them, and the fastest service would take 48 hours.
Can't we use someone that specializes in express deliveries?
Not really. I've checked this option too, but I'm not sure it would work for us because they offer a very limited loading capacity. This means that we would have several smaller partial deliveries, and we'd have to pay a lot more as a result.
What about the weekend delivery? That's possible, isn't it?
I'm afraid not. We can't deliver at the weekend because of the HGV driving ban on Saturdays and Sundays.
Oh dear. I had no idea this delivery would cause so many problems. I'll talk to GLP again, and we'll get back to you later. Thanks for your help.
No problem. Speak to you soon. Bye.
Bye.
Okay, next. Informing someone about problems. Telling someone that something cannot be handled in the way it was planned, or that something has gone wrong, can be difficult. That's why it is important to stay calm and use polite language. It is usually a good idea to say what the problem is exactly and then explain the situation. We often use beginning such as I'm afraid, I am sorry, but even if we are not responsible for the problem. First, we give a brief introduction and then go on to explain the situation in more detail. I'm afraid there is a problem with customs clearance. I'm sorry, but there will be a delivery delay. We may also want to give reasons for the problem. Example, The delay was caused by a rail strike in Italy. The consignment has to be repacked because the carton is damaged. There was a delay because of bad weather. There was a delay because of the weather was bad. We might also want to talk about contrast example when we explain that there was a problem, but it hasn't affected the outcome. Although the local wasn't secured properly, it arrived intact. Or the load wasn't secured properly, but it arrived intact. In spite of the strike, the consignment arrived on time. Despite being delayed, the consignment arrived on time. Sometimes we also need to explain the consequences of certain events. The result was that the goods didn't leave the warehouse until Friday. As a result, the shipment arrived 2 hours late. There's fog at the airport, so the flight hasn't taken off yet. Next, number 7. Complete the sentences with words from the box. Number 1. Our customer wants to ship valuable freight. We need to think about insurance. Here we use after a comma, and we have another clause, so we use so. Two, a part of the shipment seems to be damaged. Of rough handling, here we have a preposition of. We have a structure because of plus a phrase. Here this is a phrase. So here we use because of. Next, number 3. The customer needed them urgently. The goods couldn't be delivered at the weekend. This is the clause and another clause, the sub clause here, so we use although, because already although plus a clause consists of subject, verb and object. Number 4. The flight was cancelled to bad weather. Here we have to, we have a structure due to plus now. So here we use due to. Number 5. The driver had the wrong address. It took him 3 hours to deliver the package. Here we have a full stop here, and we start a new sentence. So we use as a result. Number 6. The consignment arrived on time on the customs formalities at the border. So here we use what? We use despite. despite plus gloss. Despite. Seven. We are unable to ship today. We had problems with our dispatch. We also have a structure because plus clause. Here, because plus clause. So here's also a clause. Subject, verb, and object. Because. Number 8. Being well secured, the load was damaged on arrival. Here is a phrase. So we use in spite of plus a phrase. In spite of. Okay, next. Number 8. Choose the correct words to complete these sentences. Number 1. The documents stated the wrong quantities as the shipment was not accepted at the warehouse. We have a phrase as a result. We crossed out the other words as a result. Number 2. The delay was found, noticed, or caused by an accident on the motorway. Caused by. Go with preposition by, we need cost. We cross order. Next, number 3. When I spoke to the logistics manager, it noticed, saw, turned out that they had used different packing material. Here we have preposition out. It goes together with turned. So we cross others. Number 4. Unfortunately, we are unable to deliver the consignments due to or because of technical problems in our warehouse. The rest is a phrase. It's not a sentence. A phrase. So we need what? We can't use because is a clause or sentence. So we can't use because as well as so. So it's the same with because. So we choose due to. Number 5. Although or in spite of or but the delay, the delivery will still arrive on time. Here, now. So before a now can't be although goes with a sentence or clause. So we can't use although as well as but. You hardly ever see but at the beginning of the sentence, so we can't use but. So we use in spite of with a now, the delay. Number 6. What is the cause or reason or result for this delay? Usually people will ask, what is the reason? We cross out the others. Number 9, homework. Number 10, there are 6 mistakes in this email. Can you correct them? Advice of this patch. Dear Jing, please find attach the following documents. The following documents is attached, so we need an ID of attach. Delivery note number 700-7108, packing list and shipping order. Our forwarder has just picked up the goods from our warehouse. The goods should be at your disposal at Monday, 31st October 2009. Please notice is a noun, but we need a verb, so we use note. That note that a copy of the part of the batch certificate will be sent must be in past participle, so sent to you as soon as possible by email. As soon as we receive is not correct, mistake here. Receive after letter C is letter E, I V E. Receive the original batch certificate. We will send it to you. If you have any further questions, please let me know. No, not now. Please let me know. Okay. Regards, Anna Garcia, Logistics Manager. Very good job, Logistics Manager. I have a friend, he's really good at logistics. Advice of shipments. When dealing with shipments to customers, it is common practice to advise them that a shipment has been sent. Often details on the packager and arrival times, order numbers and documents are given. We are pleased to inform you that your order has been dispatched by truck today. Order number 3012 has been dispatched by flight BA2379 today. We are pleased to advise that your order number 23/1346 was shipped on board the vessel Ocean Line. The consignment is due to arrive in Sydney on August 25. The above order has been handed over to our forwarding agents today. The consignment will be delivered to your warehouse in Brussels. Next, 11. Write a similar email informing a customer about this patch. Include the following information. Number 1, the order number. Number 2, when the consignment was sent. 3, how the consignment was shipped, road, air, rail, or sea. 4, where it will be delivered. 5. When it will arrive at the customer site. Okay, so how can we write? It's simple. order number. Six double eight, oh double nine, eight six was dispatched. Yesterday. February. Thirteenth. Bye. Barrel is simple. It will be delivered to the customer site. In Banbury. UK. It is expected. To arrive. February 15th, before 10 a.m. Okay, that's it. Next, number 12. Match the words from 1 to 5 with the pictures from A to E. Number 1 is bail. Bail is letter E. Number 2, chest. Chest is letter D. Three, barrel or cask is letter B. Four, drum. Drum is letter I. Drum. Five. Great. Great is letter C. The last one. Next. 13. Now match the items in exercise 12 with the correct definitions. So, number 1, bail. Bail is letter C. Bail. nest. Number two, just. Just is letter D. Next, number three, barrel or cask is letter I. Barrel. Cask, not cask, cask, cask. Next, number four is drum. Number four is letter A, drum. And the last one, number five, is great. Great is letter B. Great. Barrel or cask, large cylindrical container with a flat bottom and top. It is made of wood and is used for liquids. Barrel, great, wooden box made of wooden slats. It can be open or closed and is used for packing goods. Barrel, barrel, large package of fresh packed goods, often raw material, wood is tightly bound, wrapped and banded. Chest, sturdy box with a lid, which is made of metal and often used for storage. Drum, cylindrical metal container for liquids. Next, 14. USDF, International Freight Forwarders based in Chicago, give some shipping instructions on their website. Complete the sentence with words from the box. Shipping instructions as the official international freight forwarder. Number one, by Expo Chicago. So, freight forwarder appointed. We will coordinate on international shipments and arrange customs custom clearance. For this event, please carefully read the following information regarding shipping requirements for goods into the US. For importing, packing and marking, number one. Ensure that all boxes are securely packed in order to handling by carriers and on-site contractors. Number four is withstand. stand, with stand. Number two, clearly on cartons, cases are great on two sides. It's clearly Mac. Three, if you ship your goods in a container, make sure that all cartons are marked and labeled in the following manner. Number six is individually. Address, name of individually already, name of exhibitor, total in kg, total weight. In kg. Next, output chaos at Heathrow's new terminal 5. When Heathrow's terminal 5 was officially opened by the Queen in March 2008, operator BAA said that it would put the airport at the cutting edge of global travel. The complex, which cost £4.5 billion, includes 50 new aircraft stands, a large car park, as well as rail and underground links to London. It is designed to handle 12,000 bags an hour. BAA claimed that checking in for flights would be simplified for up to 30 million passengers a year by online check-in, fast baggage drop-in facilities, and sophisticated baggage handling. 2 weeks later, on launch day, however, dozens of flights in and out of the new terminal had to be cancelled due to a breakdown of the baggage handling system. By the end of the first day, hundreds of passengers were left stranded at the airport, and there was a backlog of more than 15,000 bags. What had gone wrong? On launch day, problems started almost immediately when staff and passengers had trouble locating car parks. Delayed opening of check-in then led to long queues. Additionally, workers in the baggage sorting area had problems logging onto the computer system or could not handle the RMS resource management system, which allocates baggage handlers to load or unload aircraft. As the check-in staff were not aware of the situation, they continued to add luggage to the system. As a consequence, check-in had to be suspended in the afternoon. An aviation analyst later explained that the backlog of baggage was mainly caused by problems with the terminal's three-stage baggage processing system. The first stage, the fast bag drop-off, was working as planned, but the second stage, an underground conveyor system, had become clogged up because baggage workers were not able to remove the bags quickly enough at the other end. BA said that they knew the first day would be critical because of the size and complexity of the move into Terminal 5, and that they were working hard to resolve these issues. Okay, now over to you, number one. What are the main logistics problems mentioned in this article? 2. Have you ever experienced similar problems at an airport? 3. How important is logistics for an airport? Okay, this is homework. Our lesson today is finished. See you next lesson. For the book, just visit my blog at studyenglish@home123.blogspot.com. Then you click on profession to find the book English for Logistics by yourself. Thank you for watching.